John Lilly, a noted wit. Hello and welcome to the discourse. We are discussing the university wits, the English literary heroes of pre-Shakespearean Elizabethan era. Today we will discuss the works of one of the most important university wits, who together with Christopher Marlowe paved the way for the development of Elizabethan drama. While Christopher Marlowe popularized the Senecan tragedies and his specific use of mighty lines in blank verse, John Lilly developed a new prose writing style which is known as euphuism. John Lilly was born in 1554 and he joined Oxford University at the age of 16 in 1560. He had a natural ability as a poet and he started gaining name and fame for his literary skills. In 1578, he completed his degree of MA from University of Oxford. In 1578, Lilly published Euphues, The Anatomy of Wit. He used a new writing style never used before in English. He used a lot of similes, alliterations, punning, and frequent use of Greek and Roman mythologies along with nature in his writing. This work gained fame in Elizabethan court and became a source of inspiration and imitation for other writers. His second novel was Euphues and His England, which was published in 1580. Both these works were romantic intrigue, presented with general discussions on religion, society, love, humanity, and nature in epistolary style. The story is about Euphues, an apt, intelligent, and witty student. The second Euphues book, Euphues and His England, is full of patriotism and intense praise of Queen Elizabeth as the national leader. After this novel, Lilly concentrated more as a playwright and he got control over Blackfriars Theatre, in which his initial plays including Campaspe and Sappho and Faust were performed. Most of the plays written by John Lilly were performed by Children of Paul, one of the children's company. His most successful play was Endymion. It was a romantic comedy written in euphuism, that is, in a very gentle and witty manner. He introduced macabre drama in the Elizabethan era. So John Lilly introduced macabre during the Elizabethan era. He introduced euphuism and he was the only university wit, the contemporary of Shakespeare or his predecessors, who never wrote a tragedy. In Endymion, Lilly expresses the story of a young courtier, Endymion, who is forced into an endless slumber by his former lover, Talus, because he tricked Talus into worshipping the ageless queen, Cynthia. The play was performed by Children of Paul in 1588 and it was registered in the Stationer's Register on 4th of October 1591. All the plays of John Lilly except The Woman in the Moon were performed by Children of Paul. Endymion was the first Elizabethan drama whose dialogues were written in prose. John Lilly was a literary inventor who invented new ideas and introduced them in English theatres. In Campaspe, which was performed in the court of Queen Elizabeth on 1st January 1584, he presented the story of how Alexander the Great fell in love with one of his captive, Campaspe. Alexander grants freedom to her and asks Apelles, a painter, to draw her portrait. Soon Apelles too falls in love with Campaspe and then there is a triangular love tussle between the three. At last, Alexander gives up Campaspe to Apelles and turns again to his aim of victory over the world. It was one of the first playwrights that had no moral message behind it and was only mean to entertain the audience. Campaspe is noted for the complete break from the tradition of morality plays. It was written in euphuistic style. While euphuism is now considered a derogatory style, it was very popular during the times of John Lilly when he introduced it because of then current stream of Renaissance in England. Also, Lilly introduced the mythologies in such a way that they resembled the then political scenario in England. As for example, people of his times could see Philip II in Midas. They could compare Queen Elizabeth with Cynthia, and the story of Endymion resembled the disastrous breakup between Robert Dudley and Lady Sheffield. Christopher Marlowe influenced Shakespeare in his tragedies. Shakespeare drew direct inspiration from the works of John Lilly for his romantic comedies And just like Christopher Marlowe's mighty lines were eclipsed by Shakespearean works, Lyly's romantic comedies and melodies were overpowered by romance of Shakespeare. In Love's Labour's Lost, Shakespeare drew direct inspiration from John Lyly's Love's Metamorphosis. Similarly, Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream is usually based on John Lyly's Galathea. Midas was a romantic comedy written by Lyly, which entered in Stationer's Register on 4th October 1591 and was published in 1592. It was based on Ovid's Metamorphosis, but Lyly used allegorical aspect in his work. Popular quotes by Lyly. John Lyly had a natural ability as a poet, and though he stressed more on prose, his prose also offers the poetic taste. Some of the very popular quotes of John Lyly, which are examples of euphuism, are as follows. All is fair in love and war. Many strokes overthrow the tallest oak. The source of these quotes is Euphues, The Anatomy of Wit. As the best wine doth make the sharpest vinegar, so the deepest love turneth to the deadliest hate. A penny for your thought. Love knoweth no loss. To give reason for fancy were to weigh the fire and measure the wind. There can no great smoke arise, but there must be some fire. Source of all these quotes is The Anatomy of Wit, Euphues. Marriages are made in heaven, though consummated on earth. All fish are not caught with flies. It is the eye of the master that fatteth the horse, and the love of the woman that maketh the man. In misery, it is great comfort to have a companion. Source of all these popular quotes, which are even used today, is Euphues, The Anatomy of Wit. So all these quotes are examples of euphuism. The sun shineth upon the dunghill and is not corrupted. The finest ash is made with the blunt whetstone. Again, the source is Euphues, The Anatomy of Wit. So this was all about John Lyly, a noted wit. We will continue to discuss other gems of the university wits in the upcoming videos. Keep in touch with the discourse and the history of English literature. Thanks and regards.